Hey y'all! Okay, welcome to week 28. I'm gonna apologize in advance. You guys can probably hear my daughter screaming bloody murder in the other room. She's in timeout and she doesn't do timeouts too awesome. So, anyway, that's what the noise is, but my husband's taking care of her, so. Whew. Anyway, week 28. Wow, I have so much going on, you guys. It is ridiculous. As you can see, I'm like surrounded by just random junk, basically. Her room is still not painted, which I wanted it to be painted by now, but we just have not made it out to get the paint. I'm so busy. I cannot even believe how insanely busy that I have gotten in the last couple of weeks or whatever. Anyway, week 28, everything is going awesome. We had our 4D ultrasound today, and that went really, really good. I have to admit, though, I was actually a little bit disappointed with the 4D ultrasound. Our doctor, or my doctor anyway, doesn't do the 4D ultrasound normally. Like, you have to pay an additional cost to get the 4D ultrasound. So we paid our $125 fee to get that done because we didn't get one with Zoe and we really wanted one with Piper. So we got there and everything. However, nobody told me that because I have an anterior placenta and because she's not head down yet, that it may be problematic getting a good crystal clear image. And they were right. We didn't really get any really awesome pictures, but we could definitely see her and kind of get an idea of what she looks like so far anyway. Right now, she looks a lot like Zoe did when she was born, like a lot like Zoe did. But, you know, that could easily change. It was still really awesome to see her. I got a ton of pictures. All of these are pictures, so I wanted to show you guys a few of them. And again, they're not that good. Because she said I didn't have like enough fluid around her to actually see her very good. So they're kind of grainy. But you can kind of see her right there. She's got a little chubby cheek. Let me find a different one. There's one with her arm above her head. Super cute. And we got a DVD of it too, but obviously I'm not gonna bother uploading that because that would be too complicated and I have no idea how to do it. So let's see. This is kind of a good one. She's got her little eyes closed. She's just a cutie pie. I can't wait to meet her. But yeah, we got a ton of pictures. Hang on. I can't even like show you guys. Look at all of these. Our ultrasound tech was like, well, I'm really sorry. Like, she felt awful that she couldn't really get like an awesome picture. So, look at this one. I think this one's funny. I don't know why I think that one's funny. But she felt bad that she couldn't get an awesome picture, so she just gave us, like, basically every picture that she took. Which is good, because, I mean, we paid for it, so I kind of would appreciate all of these pictures. but I'm going to have to figure out which one of those are going to go in her baby book. And I also had my, hang on one second. What? Hang on, my husband's calling me. One sec, y'all. Okay, sorry, my daughter's not wanting to take a nap, apparently. We woke up super early to go to the ultrasound, and then we've kind of just been running around town all day, and it's like 3:30 now, and she hasn't had a nap all day, so she is just beside herself with exhaustion. And when she gets that tired, like, it's impossible to get her down for a nap without her having a scream fest, so. Anyhow, after the 4D ultrasound, I went in and I had my normal 28-week appointment, I guess. she said everything looked really good. The heartbeat was good. I don't remember exactly what it was. I think it was like 156 or something like that. I'm pretty sure it was 156. she said I've gained 5 pounds this past month. However, Piper herself has gained 1.5 pounds. So she said that actually seemed pretty normal. She said I myself have probably only gained about 2. So whatever. Again, I'm not not going to stress out about the weight loss thing, or weight loss. I wish weight loss. I'm not going to stress out about the weight gain at this point because it's just ridiculous. I have 2 months left. I can suck it up and deal with it. And I'm trying to remember what else she said. Oh yeah, I am 28 weeks today. Like today I turned 28 weeks. She measured me, you know how they measure from the top of your pubic bone up, to like right below your rib cage or wherever your belly stops or the placenta stops, I don't know which. But she said I'm measuring at 33 weeks. So, she said that it's either going to be a really, really big baby or I'm going to go into labor a little bit earlier than expected. So that's interesting. I measured pretty much on target with Zoe. Like I don't remember being bigger than I was supposed to be at any point. I don't know, but it was a while ago too. So I may just not remember. But yeah, I'm measuring 5 weeks ahead of time. That is crazy. So if I'm like 33 weeks now, technically 33 weeks now, and if she's born in like 36 weeks, that's like 3 weeks away, which freaks me the heck out. I know that won't happen. I know she's not going to be born in 3 weeks. Thank God. I want her to stay in as long as she possibly can and get healthy. I really want to avoid a NICU trip. So hopefully she stays put for a while. But I mentioned that I'd been having like super frequent Braxton Hicks contractions. And she said, you know, that's normal. She said, as long as they're not super painful. However, last night, my husband and I went on a date night. Yes, I know, a miracle because we never get a date night. But we went to go see True Grit, which is an awesome movie, by the way. You guys should totally go see it. But we were in the middle of the movie, and I had a very, very painful Braxton Hicks contraction. Like, it wasn't just the tightening like I normally feel. Like, it was full-on, doubled-over pain. Like, I was hurting, and my stomach was super tight, and I was like, oh, my God. Like, it felt like a real contraction. So I'm, like, nudging my husband. I'm like, oh, my God, oh, my God, the baby's coming. I was freaking out. But then after that one really, really rough contraction, it just stopped, and it didn't happen again. And I mentioned it to my doctor today, and she said that that could potentially be a sign that I may go into early labor. So she said I need to take it easy and try to stay off my feet as much as I can. Don't stay on my feet too long, which is a big problem for me because I'm always on my feet, especially recently. I'm on my feet all the time. And I think I've been a little bit more stressed out recently than I normally would be. I know I've mentioned it before, but like I am so busy. I am a full-time student. I've got a 2-year-old at home who never goes to daycare. Like, I take care of her all day long. I'm pregnant, obviously. And I just started up my own business, which is crazy time consuming. And it's very difficult because we can't put Zoe in daycare yet because that's not something that we can afford right now. Starting a new business is very demanding. I started a photography business, and it's actually taken off, like, way faster than I thought it would. I had an engagement shoot yesterday that I did, and I was on my feet for 2 hours shooting the engagement, doing that photo shoot. And it's a lot more exhausting than I thought it would be. That was my first actual, like, job, like, you know, technically my first job. I've got 3 other engagement photo shoots booked within the next 2 weeks. I have an infant photo shoot, a 3-month portrait shoot. I have prints that I need to print out and mail to people. And I have a wedding booked in June. It's crazy. It's so crazy because I did not think that it would take off this quickly. I thought it would kind of be more of a gradual thing, but I'm very busy. I'm super, super busy now. And I feel like there's a lot of pressure, too, because I feel like I'm not, like, super, sorry, y'all, my eye is itching like crazy. I feel like I'm not, like, super professional yet or anything, so I don't charge, like, a whole lot. Like, I charge way less than most photographers in this area, but of course I can start charging more as I get better, but it's just crazy. It was so stressful because I got there and I was like, oh my gosh, because it's up to you. Like, it's up to the photographer to tell the people what to do, what positions to go in, what lighting is best, where they should turn their head. And there's a lot of pressure because that's their engagement pictures. Like, they're gonna have those forever. Like, that's a big deal. And the wedding is freaking me out too, because that's even bigger deal. Like, I'm always afraid I'm gonna miss that pivotal moment, like their first kiss or something like that, and I'm gonna be standing here fumbling with my camera or something. I don't know. But I guess that just comes with practice and experience, and it's something I love, love, love doing. So I'm super excited that I'm actually getting jobs and making money off of this now. Yeah, it's just so exciting. I don't know. It was like a big, huge freaking sigh, but... oh, and we've been baby shopping. We did a crazy, crazy baby haul like 3 days ago, and I am going to do a baby buys video this week, so you guys will definitely have a ginormous baby buy video. We bought so many things. We bought the car seat. I have the car seat sitting right here. Sneak peek. That's the car seat. But I'll go over all of that. We got the bassinet. We got, what else did we get? We got our high chair. We got a stroller. We got some storage bins. We got clothes. We got a ton of stuff. And we're still not done. We're going out tomorrow to get more stuff. So I'm going to try to wait a few more days to actually do the baby buy video so that I can just show you guys everything and not have to worry about it. And you guys have been asking about the cloth diaper video, like about my stash or whatever. Yes, I'm totally still 100% going to be doing that video. But I thought it would be better if I waited till her room was done. Like, how cute would it be? Because I have all of this stuff planned for her room, and I really just want it to be done. And that way I can just show you guys her cloth diapers when they're organized and everything. Because right now they're just in a big cardboard box in our living room because I haven't washed them yet or put them away because I don't have anywhere to put them. So I'm kind of stressing out about the baby room situation. And my husband doesn't paint. He does not paint. He hates painting with a flipping passion. So, plus he works like crazy. So I get the wonderful task of trying to paint this room by myself. It's not going to be so much fun. I hate painting too. But I have two different colors that I'm doing, like one on the, where's my hand? Ah, there it is. I've got a color that I'm going to do on the bottom and then one I'm going to do on the top. So they're going to be pretty, contrasting colors. I think it'll look good. But I'm just super excited. I'm just so excited to get everything going. I'm ready for her to be here. I cannot wait, to be a new mom again. I still have to buy a breast pump. Oh my gosh. I even like sitting here looking around this room, like you guys can't see it, but I am literally surrounded by baby stuff. It's a little overwhelming, like just thinking about all the stuff you need to get and set up and organize, and I'm nesting like crazy, so I'm cleaning the crap out of the house, and which is good. I like having a clean house. I can't stand having a messy, dirty house. It drives me nuts. But yeah, everything's going good. So I guess I'm just gonna let pregnancy brain, you guys, I'm telling you. I guess I'm just going to end this video and show you all the belly shot. The reason I don't do an actual, like, standing up, like, live belly shot, I don't know, probably just because I'm too lazy. At this point in the pregnancy, it takes a lot of energy just to stand up, and then I have to reposition the camera, and I don't want to do it. So, I already took a belly shot before I did this video, so that was just easier for me. But anyway, if you guys have any questions, leave them below. If you guys have any video requests, let me know. I'm totally going to do a review on probably all of these products that I bought a few days ago. But if you guys have any other specific requests, like, I don't know, like a question-answer video, some of you have asked about that, which I've done them before, but, I mean, things change, so I can totally do another one. Just anything at all, let me know. And leave it as a comment or send me a message or whatever. But I'll talk to you guys later. Bye, y'all.